How do negative integers work inside a computer? Let's begin with a simpler question. How would we represent negative time on a wall clock? Think about an ordinary wall clock. It has one key limitation. It shows the time, but not the date. This limitation can be turned to our advantage. We can imagine that part of the clock face refers to yesterday evening, while the rest refers to today. So when the arrow points to 11 on the clock, we could interpret it as 11 p.m. yesterday, or minus 1 hour from midnight. In this way, we've mapped minus 1 to the number 11. Notice how 1 and 11 add up to 12, or the full circle. In other words, 11 and 1 complement each other to make 12. We can say that 11 is the 12's complement of 1. We can now apply this rule, 12's complement, to find any negative time on the clock. For example, to find negative 3, take the 12's complement of positive 3, which is 9. So minus 3 hours maps to 9 o'clock. Now here's the key idea. We haven't changed the clock itself, only the way we interpret what it shows. If we had a middleman who handled all interaction with the clock for us, both input and output, only the middleman would have to know about our interpretation. Now let's move from clocks back to computers. Imagine a computer that stores integers using 4 bits. That gives us 16 possible values, or 2 to the power of 4 non-negative integers. Let's arrange all of them in a circle, just like the hours on a clock. To represent negative integers, we can reserve part of the circle. But how big should we make this negative area? That's entirely a matter of choice, since the partition exists only in our imagination. We could try making the cut where the most significant bit changes from 0 to 1. This way, we can easily recognize negative integers simply by looking at the first bit. Splitting the number circle this way divides it exactly in half, giving us the same number of negative integers as non-negative integers, including 0. Now, how would we find out where, say, minus 3 sits? We take the number 3 and find its complement with respect to the full circle, which in this case is 2 to the power of 4, or 16.
It will always be a complement with respect to some power of 2. So let's just call our rule for placing negative integers 2's complement. Using 2's complement, we find that minus 3 will be represented by
13. Unfortunately, our computer can't calculate 2's complement in the way we just described it, because 2 to the power of 4 doesn't fit in its memory. Fortunately, there's an equivalent, machine-friendly version of 2's complement. Reverse the bits and add 1.
It produces the same result. Why does 13 work so well to represent negative 3 in our computer? Because arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, and even multiplication will still produce correct results within our 4-bit memory, sometimes by wrapping around the circle. As far as the processor is concerned, negative 3 and positive 13 are indistinguishable and behave exactly the same.